Thanks for tuning in to GTO Good Old Boys. Buckle up and enjoy the show with your host, Paul Ponder.
Hey guys, I'm Paul Ponder. I'm the host of GTO Good Old Boys, and we have a bout today. It is two in-store employees that's going head-to-head on Neely Henry Saturday in the BFL.
Correct.
We've got JD at Waterfront. That's how everybody knows. And Matthew Van Meter. So as you can see, they've done squared off behind us here, and they're ready to talk about what's going to go on and who's going to beat who.
Well, it's either going to be the Coosa River beatdown or meltdown. I'm not sure which, but either way, I'm not taking second fiddle to JD. You can bank
really?
On. Yeah, no. No,
what have happening. You got to say about that, Mr. Miller?
You know, he's going to be out there scoping all day. And I'm going to be, you know, going down the bank, and he can't beat me down there.
He can't touch you.
And I can't beat him when it comes to using these fairy wands, but yeah. When it comes time to get the big sticks out, the braid and the fun stuff and the hook, setting the hook, I'm ready to go.
Well, is it that time on the Coosa?
In my opinion, on the Coosa, it's always that time, depending on, you know, if some of the lakes fluctuate more than others. But, you know, I'm kind of a one-track mind down there, and I know what I'm going to do, and I'm ready to get it done.
Let me hear about it, Mr. Forward.
You know, I say I'll use that down there. We did have a little bit of rain last night, and I'm hoping we get a little bit more rain. Honestly, I'd like to get the big sticks out and frog and flip, and I just don't want him to know what I'm going to do.
Oh, really?
But either
so
way,
this is very secretive.
It is. It is. I mean, little side bet here. I think, we're doing $20 a boat?
25.
Yeah. Okay, we're going to do 25. We're going to do a side bet. You know,
okay.
So somebody's going to win a little bit of money regardless of
What about just whoever loses buys the Buffalo Wild Wings?
All right, deal. Deal.
I mean,
deal.
Then we kind of all win no matter what.
All right, yep. Y'all seen the handshake right here.
Yeah,
they ain't much grinning going on, so this is going to get dead serious.
Oh, it's going to get serious for sure. I mean, I'll play dirty. I'll just let the air out of his tires, to be honest with you. I'm not going to lose.
Okay.
Yeah, I like free Buffalo Wild Wings, and I can eat.
Okay.
I plan on, you know, I mean, I know some little tricks to alter his equipment, you know, before the morning of the tournament. You know, he might set the hook, and, you know, his drag might be gone or something.
Are y'all going to follow each other?
Maybe.
To the tournament.
Yeah.
Maybe. And yeah.
I mean, see, look.
Uh-oh.
See,
no, look. I'm going to follow him. We're going to follow each other down
see,
there. It's all fun and games.
Is that the only time he's going to be ahead of you?
That's the only time.
Well, I'll tell you
JD,
this.
Come on.
We're both going to do a great job representing this great establishment this weekend. But and Matt's going to do great. He's going to do so good. It's just going to be 1 pound less than what I do.
What do you really want?
1 pound less.
There's something behind that. I feel like you want something. You don't have to tell me on camera. It's fine. You can tell me later. But there's something that he needs. He's being way too nice about this. So we'll see. It should be good. It's going to be fun. I love JD. You know, it's all fun and games. And we both are representing Gunnersville Taekwondo
That's right.
Outdoors. And we love this place.
Well, let me tell you, Jan and I are very, very proud to have these two that say things like that about Gunnersville Tackle Outdoors. We are a place that we want family to come in, and we want y'all to have a good time. And this is a good time right here.
Right.
I can't wait. I'm going to be fired up the whole time. But, Matt, you've got somewhere to go on Friday.
I do. We're working a show in Huntsville with Truex Outdoors, Gunnersville Tackling Outdoors, and GunnersvilleTackle.com. We'll also have 44 Outdoors and Jake Parr with Tiger Rods there. It's going to be a good time. Should be good for everybody.
Good. Now, on your side, JD at Waterfront Fishing Report. Have you got one for us?
Yeah, I tell you, I haven't been doing the best the past week. I caught plenty of fish, but I've gathered info from some of my fellow anglers that have been out there. And I mean, to start with, it's all, like I've been saying, it's hot. I mean, I've been seeing water temps from the high 80s, even, you know, right at 90, you know, right before it starts cooling off in the evening. So there's two approaches. You can pretty much go out there and, you know, and still throw a football jig or a big shake kit or go finesse with a drop shot Nico rig or just scratch all that. If you want to go have fun, go shallow, go find them shallow holes in the grass, find them active bluegill, and go catch them on a frog, pawpaw, any of the fun topwater stuff, you know, at them early and, you know, late daylight hours of the day.
So it's early and late, no middle of the day.
Right. You can catch them out deep middle of the day, but, you know, because there's still schools of fish everywhere. I mean, everywhere I'm scanning, I'm seeing those fish, but they've been really educated. They've seen all these new, you know, everything from the Sakamoto shad to the other jig head minnow bait. So, you know, somebody like me just throwing a big power fishing bait down there, I have to really fire them fish up and get lucky. But it's doable. It's just all about, you know, the right place, right time.
Oh, I got you. Matt, do you have anything to add to that?
You know, it's going to be good if we're talking about the Coosa. I think that boat number is going to play a lot of it. I mean, yeah, if you look at history down there, there's a lot of tournaments that get won very close to the launch there at Coosa Landing. And if you get a bad number, it can be an ugly day. But
and we're planning on going to the same spot. And we haven't worked this out yet. There's one stretch that we both want to start on. And, I mean, our boats run about the same speed.
Yeah.
So, I mean, we're really hoping, you know, for that good boat number.
I seen JD outside with a ball peen hammer earlier on my prop, so I may or may not get there. We don't
know. Really?
Yeah.
I was just fixing your ear. When you
hit I appreciate that, man. You're a heck of a mechanic.
The main goal is me and Matt, we're going down to the Coosa. This is the Choo Choo BFL this weekend, and there's the Bama BFL the next weekend. I might, if I do good this weekend, I probably enter that one. It just depends on how this one goes. But the thing about it is there's going to be a lot of Coosa River local hammers in this thing.
Right.
The goal, whether it's me or him, is I want to bring this back to Gunnersville, you know, as a Gunnersville boys going down
absolutely.
There.
Absolutely.
Because there's a lot, I tell you, I know a lot, there's a lot of good sticks down there.
Right, they are.
They're power fishing, they sure even you know, offshore guys, a lot to do on Neely. But my goal is just for us to bring this back here, you know, and like I said, him do great, just finished right behind me. And then, you know.
Thanks, buddy.
I like 10-piece honey barbecue boneless wings.
I got you. You already planned ahead. You better bring
10 pieces all?
I'm trying to wash my figure, Paul.
Okay.
Yeah. Hey, guys, there's a question, all right?
All right.
All right, so how much pounds are going to win this tournament?
Man, that's a tough one. I've seen Neely take 15, and I've seen it take 20. I mean, it's so hard to tell, but lack of rain, current. I mean, I'm going to say 19.
I'm going to say 17-11.
Good gracious, that's a lot higher than I thought it would be.
Yeah, well, Neely's actually got them in that
now
place.
Now, y'all talking about largemouth going to win.
There's some largemouth to get caught there. There's a lot of spots in that chain, but really largemouth's where it's at.
Okay. Shallow and mean.
Shallow and mean, for sure. And it's those fish down there, they live in the dirt.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, when it gets hot, you think here we're fishing ledges, but down there you need a shovel to catch them.
I got you.
And just like here, they don't pull a lot of current on the weekends. They might pull it, what, till lunchtime on Saturday?
Yeah.
Somewhere there's a certain time where it cuts on and off, but I mean, it's even more difficult to really figure out them spots and deep fish on the weekends. Not saying, and that's what, you know, hopefully Matt figures that out, you know, them deep fish, but. You know,
let me ask you this, Matt. You're learning the forward facing thing. If it does come another rain today and maybe another rain tomorrow, that's gonna muddy the Coosa, right?
It will. That's
gonna shut down the forward facing, right?
You know, oddly
or is
enough,
it? I don't know.
From the lakes that I've been on, that's worked for me. The dirtier the water, the easier they are to get to bite. Now, you would think that those
but
fish
can
can't
you see them?
You can't
with forward facing.
Yeah, I mean, it'll give you a little bit of an interference on the transducer. It's not as clear, but the fish have zero problem honing in on your bait in dirty water.
Okay. Now you're going to be shallow and power.
I'll be honest with you. I'm going to be shallow, which I still don't have the life scope, which is my own fault. But my 360 unit will be cut off. All my units will be cut off, and you know I'm fishing for five fish. It's Neely Henry. The thing about this lake is it can – there's a lot of people that are used to fishing up here like, oh, I don't want to go down there because they're used to how sport we are here. But I love going down there and just having a grind for five keeper bites, and that's the way I'm going to fish. I mean, I'm either going to get the right five largemouth in the boat or I'm going to come in with three for 3 pounds or whatever. So,
well, your mindset is great.
Right, I'm few rods. Well, like I said, I ain't giving myself a lot of time to pre-fish, and when I do that – you know, I'll lay six rods on the deck and just go fishing.
Well, that worked out for you
last year. Yeah.
Or was it last year?
I had just got back from Potomac, and I got my butt kicked up there, and I was actually here on a Thursday, and my dad called me and said, hey, there's a Bama BFL on Neely this weekend. I hadn't thought about it. So I just signed up for it just to go fishing that weekend.
Right.
And like I said, no game plan, no pre-fishing, just probably going to do about the same thing this year. And hope it
How'd you do
out.
Last year?
We finished 11th. Well, no, here's what's lucky about
it. He's setting the bar high. He's coming after me.
Here's
what's
crazy.
That's a double first place.
I had five for 11-11 and finished 11th. And then here's what's even crazier. That was the only Bama BFL I fished last year. when I got the text at the end of the night on my point standings, I was in 111th place.
You're kidding me.
That is a true story. All ones.
Wow.
JD can catch them.
JD can catch them.
And he Especially on the coastal, he can. We've fished together out here a little bit, and JD is a really good fisherman, and I think he could win the thing. And, you know, Neely Henry is full of surprises. I mean, the spots and the largemouth, it's so random at times, but it's going to be good. In reality, I don't think I'll be doing a lot of scoping down there. I think that it'll be a shallow bite, and there's one thing for sure that I carry in my boat at Neely Henry, and that's an extra trolling motor prop, because at some point you're going to need to change it.
That's a good point.
Yeah, you're going to get dirt shallow. But you got to control the controllables, and that's one of them. And, you know, the last time I was down there was the ABT, which did not work out too well for myself. I figure we had 10 or pounds or 11 pounds. I can't even remember. I'll be tickled with 11 pounds in this deal, because I haven't been back down there.
And that'll get you a check in this tournament.
It will.
See, I was looking at that's what's going to win it, 11 to 13 pounds.
Well, I mean, if it gets tough, I mean, it wouldn't surprise me for Neely to shut down, but there's a lot of local sticks in there that's 7 days a week.
Think they're going to go up river where it's dangerous?
You'll have a mix. I've ran both ends of that place, and when they really release water, it can be really good up there. But if not, I'd rather go back the other way.
Stay down.
Yeah, I'd rather stay down. It's just, it fits me better.
I got
a lot of docks, a lot of bank grass and stuff like that, water willow.
I feel like me and Matt together, I feel like we both don't want to be a lot of current. We want that upriver about to be tough, because like he said, a lot of the locals will go up there. So the tougher the conditions are there for everybody, the better they are for us, really.
And it fishes small. When you get that kind of crowd up there and everybody tries to go that direction, you're in trouble.
How many do you think will be in it?
It's hard to say. Once you
100?
Get, yeah, I'm going to say probably 100. When you get down to the end of the year on the BFL, you usually have some guys that drop out. It's hot, too. It's hot, and it can shake up the point standings. I think Fisher and I is still leading that deal.
He'll be down there.
He's going to be down there. I told him the other day I need him to bomb it so I can
get this off. So. You're sitting very good. Fisher agreed with that.
Yeah, he loved that statement.
Exactly.
I think I'm sitting six. He's in first. Yeah. He's catchable, but he needs to miss on one, and that's one thing Fisher don't do is miss.
Right.
So, and then we go from here to a Wheeler tournament for a two-day event, which sets right up in his wheelhouse.
Exactly.
So it's uphill battle.
But, you know, Fisher was raised without forward facing, so he has learned from the best.
He has,
and he's put a lot of time. Yes, that's what I was fixing to say. So he's done a lot on his own.
There's no replacement for time on the water.
He can power fish, plus he can forward face.
Yep. Yep.
And so, you know, he's going to be a tough one to contend with.
Yep.
And are you going to call him if you beat him?
Me? Oh, absolutely. I'm going to – I say that. I mean, you don't want to poke the bear too much. And
you better poke him while you can.
I don't know about that. Man, the Nyes, I love that family. They're good people.
This is going to be good.
I'm definitely not going to poke Fisher too bad. Fisher, if you listen, I'm sorry, buddy.
That's right. Fisher, you're on top, buddy. You got a target on your back. You better watch out.
No, that's a fact. You're on top. You got a target on your back.
That's it. JD, what do you think about it?
Well, with what y'all are saying, what makes me feel good is that I haven't been able to fish a lot of BFLs this year. So for me, the points, I ain't worried about any points. So,
right.
I mean, I'm going down here to – I'll probably get in the Wheeler 2 day. Usually it's on Gunnersville, so I ain't sure if I'll do that or not. But, I mean, for this is just a one shot. We're just going to go fishing. And,
right.
You know, but I do wish Matt the best and the points. You know, him and Fisher both having really good years. And, heck, I would love to see all three of us, you know, wind up good, you know, all representing GTO.
I would, too. Exactly.
I'd say that the potential's there. And, you know, it – like I said, you know, I don't think it's going to take a lot of weight to get a check. It's going to take a – it's going to take over 16 at least to win. But, you know, just staying in that check range, you know, be pretty simple.
Right.
Just
it's going to be exciting if it takes 16 to win. It's going to be good. What's it going to take getting top 10?
Top 10, I'm going to say it's going to take probably 12.5-ish.
12.5-ish top 10.
Yeah.
There's actually some big largemouth in there that can show up and shake that leaderboard up. I mean, matter of fact, last time I was down there, I had one right at 5.5. And if you get a couple of those bites a day, you can really shake things up. But it just depends. I mean, like I said, it's hot.
Yes.
It can all change in a day.
So. What about fish care? Let's talk a little bit about fish care. Why not?
You know, like when I leave for a tournament, when it's this hot, I buy a 20-pound bag of ice just for the live well, and that kind of gets you going. Of course, I've got it in one side and then the fish in the other.
Right.
On this deal where you're doing a random draw, you can't do that because you've got a co-angler. So I usually open up one of the back storage compartments and just use it for ice. That way I can transfer it to the live well. But the thing is, you've got to have some sort of treatment, whether it be G juice or what have you, to take that chlorine out of the water.
So, okay. So you put it in before you leave out? I mean, before you...
I do put a bag in the live well before I leave. And okay. I don't,
you fill your live well up?
Usually.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll put a 20-pound bag in. I don't get water from the... where we're taking off.
Okay.
There's too many contaminants in the water mm-hmm. there to fill your live well. You need to do that on your first stop.
Okay.
Don't do like I did and leave the bag in there and it get into your live well and then you have a whole nother problem.
Gotcha.
Done that recently.
Gotcha.
But yeah, fish care is important. You've got to have ice in these events because
you. How often do you check them?
Pretty regularly. I mean, you
every 30 minutes or so?
Yeah, you need to stay on top of them and you need to fill your live well up on the first stop because that's the coolest water. As that sun comes up, that water heats mm-hmm. up quick. You've got to do it at your first stop, and about every 30 minutes, you need to keep it.
So you fill your live well, your first stop, that's the first thing yep. you do is fill your live well up and shut it mm-hmm. off.
Yep.
I mean,
yep. And close when it. When I catch that first fish, I start the live well. And my recirc and my fill run all day long, and I'll go through a bottle of G juice in a day. I mean,
okay.
You got to take care of them.
Do you ever put new water back in?
Yeah, with that fill and the recirc run.
Yes.
Yeah, it'll okay. pump fresh water in. There's no other way that I know about to do that.
Mm-hmm.
So just constant fresh water, constant recirculation, and G juice.
Okay.
Every hour or so.
You tell us how you do yours.
So along with Matt, you know, when I get up my ice Saturday morning, I'll get an extra 20-pound bag of ice or so, you know, and have it to add, you know, into my live well. Honestly, after blast off, I won't ever add ice again. Now, if I was fishing like out here and catching fish out of deeper than 10 foot, I would have more ice throughout the day. Thankfully, down there, them fish are pretty dang tough. But that does not mean that we're not going to take care of them. So I'll have ice my live well in the morning. As soon as I get to some fresh water on my first mm-hmm. spot, I'll pump in. Once I fill my live well, I'll turn the recirculator on. I'll go ahead and throw some G juice in there. I'll turn the oxygenator on, and I'll never look back all day long. And them fish will be – they'll be just fine.
Does it matter if you've got largemouth in there compared to spots? It seems to me spots are a little tougher than what largemouth is when it comes to that.
Them coosa spots, man, them things are tough.
That's right. A fact.
Tough as nails. Like they'll be biting your finger off when you get them alive at 230 when it's 95 degrees.
Right.
And then large, and like I said, because I mean, you know, unless we wind up fishing a little bit deeper down there, you know, we're not going to worry about fizzing fish using fin clips, so it'll be a lot less stress on the fish.
Right. I see what you said.
Because they're already in pretty shallow hot water. So as long as you're putting them to like an oxygenated, circulating water environment, you know, they'll come in just fine.
All right. Do you have to watch about how much ice you put in to put them in a shock mode?
You can definitely shock them. You don't want to put too much. The big thing, though, is back to that chlorine. You've got to have some sort of treatment to offset that. It's no different than what we do at the bait tank here when we right. change that water out. You've got to have some sort of treatment.
We dechlorinate it.
Yep, right. And you because that can do as much harm as anything.
It can kill them in a hurry.
It can, yep.
Now, the chlorination in ice, guys, can kill a fish in a hurry.
Yep.
I mean, I'm one of those guys. I think people have killed fish by using too much ice. In my opinion, you know, keeping your water from getting too hot is really important, but I think just having the oxygen in there is the most important thing.
Right.
Because there was a time to where I was stubborn and in my old boat, and I almost never used ice, and I never had fish die, but I never ever let the water sit still.
Right.
You've always got it agitating some way all day long. But as the years going on, which my last boat had darker live wells, so it actually stayed cooler easier.
Right.
And this boat, my water seems to warm up faster, so now I use a little bit of ice.
Oh, okay.
But definitely not using too much ice, I think, is a bigger problem than just not using ice at all.
All right. What about bouncing around as you're riding? Do y'all do anything for that or?
No, not really. I mean, once you close that live well, once you get them to where you think they're good, I think you shut it and keep it shut until you need to check them again. As far as riding around, nah.
Okay.
They'll be fine. Yeah. I mean, and you could run that whole coosa chain and still be fine because it's not that big anyway. So,
and my boat ain't fast enough neither.
Yeah, me neither.
It ain't fast enough to hurt them neither.
Right. Now, if we were going out on this lake when they were blowing, you know, pulling on a current and winds blowing up current and stuff, right. Or if we were on a big body of water, you know, then you might want to throw some poo noodles in there to kind of keep from hitting the top. But, I mean, you know, there shouldn't be any fear on that this weekend, I don't think.
Gotcha. Well, what else you got? Let's go back to the verses. Let's close it out with versing. JD versus Van Meter.
Well,
that's got a ring to it, right?
It does got a ring to it. It's going to sound even better when he's paying that Buffalo Wild Wing check.
Well,
we're going to have to do a follow-up on this.
Yeah, you will.
It's got to be a follow-up. JD, don't hang it head.
I wish Matt the best of luck, but I mean he just can't beat me down in the Coosa. You know, look, I can't beat him. I can't beat him when he's scoping. But like I said to begin with, we're getting to where, you know, it's my wheelhouse. Not saying the lake, but it's my fishing style, and I'm gonna have fun. And I ain't gonna worry about it.
Right.
I'm going for the five bites, and if I can hook him and get him in the boat, then I'll have good Buffalo Wild Wings.
So you're going for the five bites with nothing. You're going naked.
Yeah, like naked.
No forward facing, no grass, no nothing. You're naked.
Yeah, I'll have that stuff on the boat, but it won't be turned on.
There you go.
I mean, it's going to be hot down there, and I think.
Are you going to have any clothes on?
Well, that's what I'm getting at. I think when you said that, I think he's thinking naked.
That's what I was thinking.
Yeah, so JD's naked.
No.
And I just be honest with you, I was backing out of it right then. I was like, I'm scared of this guy. He's going to fish naked. So we're done with this challenge.
No, that ain't what I was talking about.
I don't have enough sunscreen to do that.
We ain't got enough eyes to see it.
Well, wow. We got some sunbum up there. We're going to keep you from burning. You know, you're a little pale-complected, being a redhead. Them gingers, they burn easy, and he's fixing to get burnt down there at the Coosa when he has to buy them Buffalo Wild Wings.
Yeah. Uh-oh, guys. Here it is.
I got you, bro.
J.D. Miller, Matthew Van Meter, the showdown at Neely Henry. It's on the way. Y'all feel free to watch it because we're going to have a follow-up. Thank y'all for tuning in, and y'all have a great day.